Let's now talk about what's probably Krita's most fundamental tool, the Freehand Brush tool. You can access it by using the B key or by clicking on the brush icon in the toolbox. As the name suggests, this is the tool you'll be using for all of your freehand brush work. Krita focuses on digital painting, and this is where it really shines. For one, all of the shape drawing tools in the toolbox will use your currently selected brush preset to draw on the canvas. But more importantly, in Krita, your brush presets can store blending modes, opacity and flow. They can paint with image filters like blur or sharpen, and they can smudge or mix colors. As we will see in a moment, every brush preset can also be turned into an eraser, which means that all of the shape drawing tools can do that as well. This logic makes Krita's approach to drawing both easy and flexible at the same time. This tool works with brush presets. You can find them in two different places. The first place is the brush presets docker. By default, it is hidden behind the layers docker in the second tab called brush presets. You just have to click on the tab, and then you will find a list of available brushes. You can also access it as a floating panel by clicking the icon with four squares in the toolbar. You can also press the F6 key. Just click on any icon to load the corresponding brush preset. Then, with the freehand brush tool selected, you can use it to paint on the canvas. There is a lot to say about the brush presets, and we'll come back to it later. But for now, just notice that there is an example stroke drawn on every icon. This gives you a sense of what every preset does. And one last note, colored brush strokes often correspond to smudge or color mixing brushes. We'll look closer at the way brushes are organized and represented later in the training. For now, just take your time, have fun, experiment with a variety of presets to find the ones that you like. Let's talk about resizing the brush and changing the opacity. There are three ways for you to change the size of your brush. You can shift-click and drag on the canvas to resize it on the fly. The bracket keys on the keyboard resize the brushes with fixed increments. They also snap the size value of your brushes to round numbers. Last option, you can use the slider in the toolbar and just click and drag on it. Right next to it, there is a slider to change the opacity of your strokes. Now we know how to pick brushes and change their core parameters. But a common problem when we draw with digital painting applications is that our strokes are imprecise. They tend to be jagged. Especially if you have little experience working with a graphic tablet, it is very hard to draw smooth lines. Krita comes with a few built-in brushes smoothing options to improve your line quality. Maybe you don't know what brush smoothing is. The idea is that it delays your strokes a tiny bit, by a few milliseconds, to give the application the time to smooth out your input. You do get a little lag, often it's even hard to feel, but you benefit from a much, much greater line precision, something that's normally really hard to achieve. The smoothing options can be found in the Tool Options docker. This is the third tab hidden behind the Layers docker. There are three options for you to choose from, but let me say it straight. The one I recommend is the Stabilizer. Let me still run you through the smoothing types. Basic smoothing doesn't have any parameters. It applies a minimal amount of smoothing to remove jaggedness in your brush strokes. Weighted smoothing offers a few options to fine-tune the smoothing effect. The distance slider is the most important option here. It controls the strength of the smoothing and the lag it will induce. The last option, the stabilizer, is a tiny bit more advanced than the weighted smoothing. It can turn your freehand brush tool into a lazy brush if you check the delay option, which means it adds a little dead zone around your brush in which your input gets ignored. This is used to draw sharp angles in general with smoothing on. But the stabilizer can also smooth all of your tablet's input, while weighted smoothing will only affect your pen's position and pressure. Okay, that's a lot on smoothing, but that's a very, very useful function. So smoothing is great to have, but should you always use it? The answer is no. I recommend that you use it only to ink your sketches and for painting jobs that require precise brushwork. When you are just sketching or shading a painting, you will get faster feedback from the application by deactivating all smoothing. And instead of literally deactivating it, setting the options to no smoothing, you can actually just drag the distance slider of the stabilizer all the way to the left. This will reduce the lag to the point where you can't feel it anymore. Okay, we know how to draw smooth lines and how to pick brush presets. The only thing we're missing is an eraser. Eraser is a bit special in Krita. It is a blending mode. We'll come back to blending modes later, but for now, all you need to know is that those modes change the way your brush strokes blend with the existing pixels on the canvas. As Krita features an eraser blending mode instead of an eraser tool, it allows you to erase with any type of brush. To toggle the eraser mode, you have to press the E key. Pressing this key both changes the blending mode in the toolbar's drop-down menu to eraser, and it activates the eraser icon right next to it. You can click on that icon to achieve the same effect. When it's active, painting will remove pixels on the canvas instead of adding them. So remember that, press the E key to toggle the eraser mode of your brush on and off. By default, switching to the eraser mode preserves your brush size. I prefer to have a different brush size for painting and for erasing. Thankfully, there is an option for that. To activate it, we have to click on the Edit Brush Settings icon. It can be found on the left of the Brush Presets icon. You can also open this panel by pressing F5. At the bottom of it, there is a little checkbox called Eraser Switch Size. Just click on it, and from now on, your eraser and your brushes will have different sizes. Some of you will like the way the eraser works, but I'm sure some will want some more flexibility. That's my case. Sometimes I want to paint with a soft brush and erase with a hard brush to control my edges. Krita offers two ways to do that. One of those involves the pop-up palette, which we will look at in the next video. But you can also use the slash key to switch between your current brush preset and the last one you selected. That way, if you pick an eraser and another preset to paint with, the slash key will allow you to switch between the two. We've already seen a lot of things in this video, but there's a last very important manipulation I have to share with you. To undo and redo operations, you respectively need to press the Ctrl-Z and Ctrl-Shift-Z key combinations. Now we can paint and erase, it's time to learn how to pick colors and more with the pop-up palette. We'll do just that in the next video.